Let's move on to the questions. I have picked the past paper questions. About four questions I have picked today. So we'll see, we'll try to cover all these questions today's session. Okay, so let's move on to the first question. The following transactions took place in November 2012 between Gregory and his credit customer Roberto. Okay, so you are given the transactions with regard to Gregory. Okay, his credit customer is Roberto. Okay, now when you get a question like this, what you should do is, okay, you have to ask basically three questions. Okay, so what are the questions that you need to ask? Okay, the first question is, you need to ask, let me change this. Who is your buyer? Who is your seller first? Who is the seller? The second question, who is the buyer? This is very, very important. Okay, then the third question, in whose books of accounts? Okay, in whose books of accounts you need to record these transactions? Okay, so based on this, can you tell me who is the seller? Who is the seller? Who is the buyer? Can anyone let me know who is the seller and the buyer?
Gregory is the seller.
Yeah.
Roberto is the buyer.
Buyer. Okay. The following transactions took place in November 2012 between Gregory and his credit customer. It's very clear, no? Customer means the Roberto is the buyer. So he is the buyer and Gregory is the seller. Is that clear? Okay. So let's go through the question. On 1st November, Roberto owed Gregory £500. Okay. On 4th November, Roberto purchased goods. List price is £600, less 25% trade discount. On 12th November, Roberto returned goods with a list price of £80. On 24th, Roberto paid the balance due on November 1st by check after deducting a cash discount of 5%. So last week I discussed about trade discount and cash discount. Okay, so I have uploaded this video, so you can, if you want, you can watch the video. Okay, so last week I discussed about trade discount and cash discount. Okay, now when you get a question like this, first and foremost, you need to identify who is the seller, who is the buyer. Okay, so after identifying this, so what you can do is the buyer is the purchaser, no? He is the purchaser. So purchaser means he is the creditor, no? Am I right? Buyer is the purchaser. And he is the creditor. So therefore, his balance should be a credit balance. Is that clear? Is that clear? Okay. So buyer means he is the purchaser. He is a purchaser. Why? No, from the point of view of seller, he will be the creditor, no? Is that clear or do you have any doubts? Seller, what he does, he sells goods. Okay?
Yeah.
When he sells, okay, his customer will be his debtor, no? His customer will be his debtor. His customer will be his debtor. So therefore, debtor's balance is debit. From the buyer's point of view, buyer is the purchaser. Okay. Since he's purchasing from his supplier, supplier is his creditor. And the creditor balance should be credit. Is that clear? Any questions?
Yeah.
Okay. So therefore, what you can do is just to memorize this, you can say, if he's a seller, he sells. Therefore, the seller, his customer becomes debtor. So therefore, debtor balance is debit, SSDD. Just remember this in case if you forget. Seller sells. To his customer, he becomes the debtor and his balance is always debit. And on the other hand, buyer, what he does, he purchases from his supplier. Supplier becomes creditor, his balance is a credit, BBCC. Just take it down. Any questions? Please, if you have any doubts, please clarify then and there. Seller sells. So as a result of that, the customer becomes the debtor and the debtor's balance is debit, SSDD. The buyer purchases goods from his supplier. Supplier becomes creditor. So creditor's balance is credit. Always when you purchase, there will be a creditor, it will be credited. When you sell, the customer is always your debtor and debtor balance is a debit balance. SSDD, BPCC. Okay, remember that. Okay, now with regard to this question, who is the buyer, who is the seller? Okay, seller is Gregory. Seller is Gregory. Then who is his customer? Roberto. Roberto is his customer. So therefore, he becomes a debtor, right? So debtor becomes a debit balance. Okay. Roberto is Gregory's customer. So therefore, he is a debtor. So Gregory sells goods. So Roberto customer becomes his debtor. Therefore, his balance is a debit balance. Okay. So you can remember SSDD. SSDD. Okay. Okay. Now, again, we'll go through the question. On first, Roberto owed Gregory 500. Okay, so we went through these transactions. Now, what is required? Required, prepare Roberto's account in Gregory's ledger. This is very important. The third point, which I told you, no? In whose books of accounts these transactions to be recorded? In whose books of accounts? Gregory. Gregory means seller's books of accounts. Okay, so therefore, in the seller's book, Roberto will be his customer. So therefore, he's a debtor. Okay, so Roberto is his debtor, no? If he's a debtor, his balance should be a debit balance, no? Is that correct? So Roberto owed Gregory $500, £500. So therefore, this is the opening balance, no? Where do you record the opening balance? First, November, how much? Balance brought forward 500. Okay, why on the debit side? This is the credit side. Okay, so why we debit is our debtor. So debtor balance should be always a debit balance. Is that clear?
Yes.
Okay, good. Then on 4th, Roberto purchased goods. Okay, so Roberto purchased goods from whom? From Gregory. List price is 600 less 25% trade discount. Okay, so what is the entry that you need to record here? Can anyone tell me? How do you record this transaction?
It's on the debit side.
On the debit side. Okay. Shenara, how much you have to debit to Roberto's account?
450.
450. Very good. Why 450? Bashini? Why 450? Why you need to record 450? Samira, why you need to record 450? Is that correct? Okay, so yeah. So why you need to record 450? Because the trade discount, you have to, you should know the difference between trade discount and cash discount. Okay, the trade discount is given to a customer. Okay, the main objective of trade discount is to provide a customer, the long-standing customer, loyal customer. Okay, for loyal customers and long-standing customers, the supplier will give a discount at the time of selling, at the time of selling, the initial selling. Okay, and also either to a long-standing customer or to give a bulk purchasing, bulk discount. You understand? If a customer buys in bulk, in that case, the supplier will give a discount at the time of selling. So which is known as trade discount. Okay, so that is trade discount at the time of selling. Okay, so main objective is either to encourage the long-standing customer, loyal customers, or to encourage bulk purchasing. These are the main objective. Okay, bulk purchasing and to long-standing loyal customers to encourage. Okay, to encourage the customers to purchase more. So that is the main objective of a trade discount. Okay, now when a trade discount is given, the discount is given at the time of selling. So which means on the face of the invoice, the discount will be deducted. So when you take an invoice, okay, for example, let's say this is the invoice. Okay, so this is the list price. How much is the listed price? How much? 600. 600 and 25% discount, no? 25% trade discount will be 150. So therefore, your discounted price, that, okay, this is the discounted price, 450. So this is what you need to record. You need to record 450, not 600. We don't consider the trade discount in the books of accounts. Don't consider, because it's given at the time of selling on the face of the invoice. So therefore, we don't record this in our books of accounts. Instead, what is our, to be paid? Only 450. That has to be recorded, okay? Now, Roberto purchased goods list price 600 less 25% trade discount, which is 450, okay? So I told you Roberto is the customer or the debtor, okay? When he purchases, his account should be what? Debited. Debtor should be debited. So go to his account and you can say what? Sales, no? Sales. What is the date? 4th November sales, 450. Is that clear? Any doubts? Okay. So let's move on to the next transaction. On 12th, Roberto returned goods with a list price of 80 pounds. What is this transaction? It's a return. Who has returned the goods? Roberto, the customer or the debtor has returned the goods. It's a sales return. From the point of view of Gregory. So we are recording in the books of Gregory. So therefore, from the point of view of Gregory, Roberto is his customer. Customer is returning the goods. So therefore, it's a sales return. Okay? It's a sales return. So if it's a sales return, what you should do?
Credit
the debtor. Okay. If you debit the customer sales, the sales return should be credited. How much to be credited now? On 12th November, can we credit £80?
It has to be with the trade discount.
Exactly. Okay. Don't forget this, because the listed price for 600 pounds we purchased after the discount of 25, which was 450. You understand? Now you are returning the goods at the listed price, but we did not record 600 listed price in our debtor's account, did we? No. So therefore, how you can record 80 here? It's wrong. Please understand this. We did not record the listed price here. We recorded 450 after the trade discount. So therefore, if you credit 80, which is wrong. So therefore, what you should consider is what is recorded. Recorded is the discounted price. So therefore, you should credit the discounted price. So how much is the discounted price?
60.
Exactly. How did you calculate? 80. From that, you calculate 25%. How much is that? 20. So if you deduct this, which will be 60, because the trade discount percentage was 25. So when you return, you will return the discounted value. So therefore, you need to credit on 12th November. What is this? Sales return. So please remember, I am recording only the one entry. Okay. So the other account has to be debited. Okay. When you credit the debtor, you need to debit the sales return account. Please remember, always when you record transaction, there has to be a dual impact. There has to be a dual impact. So if you debit one account, always you credit the other account. But in this question, you are required to record only the debtor's account. So therefore, what is relating to the debtor's account only you have to record. Other accounts you don't need to open. You need to record. Okay, please remember that. So when you credit this account, you have to open a sales return account and you have to debit, which is not required here. When you recorded the sales account, you debited the debtor's account. Where do you credit? You have to credit your sales account, which is not required in this question. Please remember that. This is the dual impact. Okay. Now on 24th, what's happening? Roberto paid the balance due on November 1st by check. So what is the balance he is settling now? He's settling. Yeah. So basically, he had an opening balance of 500, and subsequently on 4th November, he purchased 450, but he is settling, he is paying the amount due on 1st November. Not this balance, only this balance. Okay. So Roberto paid the balance due on 1st November by a check after deducting a cash discount of 5%. So on 24th, how much will be received by the seller or the Gregory from Roberto, the debtor? How much he is receiving? Can anyone tell me?
475.
Okay. So Roberto paid the balance due on November 1st by a check after deducting a cash discount of 5%. So what is a cash discount? What is the purpose of giving a cash discount? Can anyone tell me? It's not a prepayment. Okay. Basically, cash discount is given to a customer. This is very important. When you write your answer, you have to write in this way. Okay. Is given to a customer as an incentive to pay their accounts promptly. Okay. So the businesses, they need cash. When you sell on credit, the cash is tied up. Cash is with the customer. We don't get the cash immediately because it's on credit. If it is 30 days, the 30 days, the seller will not get the cash. Okay. If the customer doesn't pay, what will happen? He will have cash flow problem. Cash problem. Okay. So in order to collect the cash promptly, what he has to do? He has to give the customers discounts as an incentive to pay their balances, pay their accounts promptly. Okay. So if they don't pay, what will happen? Sometimes customers will not pay. So it will become a bad debt. So bad debt means you will not receive cash from the customers. It's a loss to the company. It's a loss to the seller. If you don't, what do you call, get the cash on time. Okay, if you are given the customer 30 days, within 30 days, you should collect the money from the customers. If they don't pay, it will become a bad debt, or it will become, so therefore it will become a bad debt if you don't settle on time. So therefore, you give cash discount as an incentive to pay their accounts promptly. So that if you give a cash discount to a customer, which will reduce the number of bad debts, and also it will improve the cash flow of the business. What is the purpose of giving a cash discount? To collect the cash promptly so that it will improve the cash flow of the business. And also it will reduce the number of bad debts. Your customer will not become your bad debt. You understand? So the customer will pay promptly, so it will improve the cash flow statement of the business. Okay, this is the main objective of cash discount. Okay, so now how much is paying now? 475. So what is the entry that you should record? How do you record that? Yeah, so when Gregory, the seller, receives cash from Roberto, his bank account will be debited, no? Bank account should be debited. And where you should credit? His account. Okay? So, amount to be received 500, he paid 475. So, therefore, the balance should get reduced. On 24th November, bank account 475. Is that clear?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Then what happens to the remaining balance 25? Outstanding 500, 475. What is 25?
Discount.
Who said that?
Me.
Huh? Who is that? Tahira, what?
Bhashini.
Bhashini, okay. So that is the discount allowed. Why discount allowed? We are allowing our customer to pay 475 instead of 500. So therefore, we allowed him to enjoy the discount. Okay, he will enjoy the discount. Okay, so therefore we are allowing discount allowed. Please enjoy this discount. Okay, so he will enjoy, but from business point of view, it's a loss. No, we are losing this money. It's a loss. It's an expense to the company. So therefore, you credit this account. Where do you debit? You debit discount allowed account. This account is not required, but for explanation purpose, I am explaining you. Discount allowed account will be debited. It's a loss. It's an expense. Expenses are always on the debit side. Okay? So you credited this account. You debit the discount allowed account. Okay, that is the double entry. Is that clear? Okay. Now, what is required? Prepare Roberto's account in Gregory's ledger for the month of November 2012. Balance the account on 30th November 2012. And bring the balance down on 1st December 2012. So balancing of accounts, this we discuss. What you should do, how do you balance off the accounts? Take the highest total. Okay, so Which side has the highest total?
The debit side.
Debit side. Debit side total is 950. So therefore, both side you take 950. On 30th November, balance carried forward, how much?
390.
Okay, then 1st December, balance brought forward, how much? 390. You had to show this. You had to show this. You had to show this. All these figures, you will be given marks. Very, very important.